Hello everyone. Today I will be showing you how to install Dataiku on Windows operating system. Let's get started. So to start, we have to type Dataiku on Google. Click on this website. Once the website has loaded, click on Get Started. And here on Get Started, when you scroll down, you will see a free edition. Select your system. For this video, I will be installing Dataiku on my Windows. So there are several options to install Dataiku on Windows. We can install Dataiku on Linux by GUI Linux installation. We can use a cloud image for Amazon Web Services. But for this video, I would be using a VirtualBox or a VMware. These are the steps and the prerequisite for installing Dataiku on your Windows operating system. First of all, we need to install the VirtualBox. So click on this link and download the product. Once the VirtualBox is downloaded, click on it. Yes. Next. I'm going to install on my program files. Click on Next. I will select all the options and click on Next, and I'll click Yes again, and finally I'll click on Install. Gonna take a few minutes. Till then, let's see the next step. The next step is to download the DSS image. Click on the link and it will start to download. Once the setup is finished, we're going to click on Start the Oracle VM VirtualBox and click on Finish. And if everything went well, you should be able to see something like this. So because I already have Dataiku image installed, that's why I have this image shown over here. But for you, the screen could be a little different. So it's saying that it will take another 10 minutes to install. Let's wait. So once your recording of VirtualBox is completed, you should open your VirtualBox and something like this will appear. So because I have already installed Dataiku before and I've run it before, that's why I'm able to see Dataiku here. But for you, the screen should be different, right? All you have to do is click on File, Import, and choose the location where you downloaded your Dataiku. Open the file and click on Next. Make sure the settings are default and click on Import. After your import is completed, you should be able to see the image on your VirtualBox. Before starting, I want you to click on the settings. And here you will see that there is an invalid setting. To clear this error, you have to click on the screen and choose VMSVGA. Also, I would highly advise you to increase the memory as per your system. And also, if you can increase the processor, do increase the processor too. Click on OK and click on Normal Start. Select the first option, which is the Linux 7 core option. So my Linux VirtualBox is successfully running. And now I have to type my login ID, which is Dataiku. That pop-up window came because I clicked on the screen. So mouse is not detected in the VirtualBox. And after that, I have to write the password. Which is again Dataiku. In the password field, you won't be able to see the password you would be typing. Therefore, I highly advise you to be accurate and be a little slower than usual. After accepting the login ID and password, you will clearly see a line like this. Dataiku @localhost and symbols. So before the Dataiku starts, it takes some minutes to process everything. And let's wait. Once the Dataiku will start running, we will see a different screen. If you face any type of an error while installing or while uploading the image of Dataiku, let me know in the comment and I will promptly help you. Right, so for me, the Dataiku has successfully started. How I know this is because it says that the HTTP 127.0.0.1 :10,000 is been loaded. So all I have to do is take a new screen, just type the number, which is 127.0.1 here. And Voila, here we go. So if you are able to see the screen, that means that your Dataiku has successfully been installed. Now it's asking you some of the question which you should answer correctly. Do you already have a DSS license file? I do not have, so I will click on no, and I will click on free edition, which is unlimited access to a single user. Earlier this used to be access to three users, and they have detected it to only single user. You have to share your personal details over here and then click on next. After clicking on next, you will receive your login ID and password. 99% of the cases, the login ID and password for the free editions remain as admin and admin. So let's get started. So here in a login page, as Dataiku told us, we have to type admin. And in our password, we also have to type admin. And then we'll click on login. Here we are. So this is the main home screen of Dataiku. And from here, let's go to the next video.